Okay, welcome to another Orbiter 2010 video. And in this video, I'm back here at KSC, and I just want to try to repeat the flight that I did where I was trying to go from KSC to Habana. And again, this isn't really a speed run, but I want to try to get there fairly quickly. So I kind of already went through the steps of setting up my MFDs. I've already got map MFD dialed into Habana, and I've already got glide slope 2 set up, so we're ready to go. And again, this is the default scenario that comes with the XR2 Ravenstar. It's called takeoff to ISS, but we're not going to the ISS. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and go. I've got my joystick here in front of me, so we're good to go. Heading almost straight south, so we're in the right position. External cooling's off, all that, so here we go. Full power on the throttle, get up to speed, and we'll back off the throttle a bit. There's our V1 call out.
Rotate,
so back off throttle, pitch up. And make sure the wheels are up.
Gear up.
Raise the landing gear, full power on the throttle. Last time I did this, I started my braking too late, and I think I might have been maybe pushing a little bit too hard in terms of the speed, so we'll be a little more careful on that this time, hopefully. And you can see in glide slope there, the position indicator is kind of coming around. We're only 10 degrees off. It's probably enough pitch up for what we're doing here. And go ahead and switch HUD colors. Let's see, that's going to be all H. Go with yellow, I guess. Put in a little bit more bank to get in line a little bit faster. I also changed the HAC. Actually, I'm overshooting my position now a little bit. I noticed last time I had it set on right, right left or something, RC maybe, and you'll notice there's a difference between the hack and the range when you do that. But if you have it set on RO, it's closer, and that just means that it's open, so you're not gonna try to land and, you know, do the whole circle around the hack, which I never do. And so I forgot to set it to open. I noticed that when I was looking at the playback. So we're at 20 kilometers. We're going to want to get a bit higher. Don't want to go too crazy with it. I'm not going to use scram engines either, because I'm not really trying to be efficient here or anything. Go ahead and bring that nose down a bit though. And this is just something I'm doing kind of out of curiosity. Bring the nose down a lot.
Mach 3.
Kind of overshot the altitude last time quite a bit more than I wanted, so I'm going to try to be a little bit more careful about that on this flight as well. It's a very short flight in terms of, you know, the kinds of speeds that we're dealing with here. Can see there in glide slope that my position's getting a little bit off. That's because I'm banking down. But as soon as as soon as everything gets settled, I'll be fine. There we go. Now you can see my nose is above the velocity vector, so I'll start bringing that back around. Now I'm actually going to be going down though if I'm not careful. I don't really want to lose altitude necessarily. I think last time I pushed myself all the way up to about 3,000 meters a second. That might have been overdoing it a little bit, but I want to get, you know, pretty close to that number, because I think the main issue last time was just that I started the braking way too late, like way, way, way too late. Okay, now I'm going to take advantage of this time here where things are pretty well centered. I'm going to come over to this view. And get everything set up here, which I should have taken care of this before I ever took off, but just wasn't thinking about it. Still gonna put in a hard brake here, 55 degrees, something like that. Alright, back to this view here. 2,500 meters a second. Actually, let me come over to this view so I can keep an eye on the temperature. Bring the nose up a touch. Get up into some thicker, or rather some thinner air to keep the temperature down. But not too much more than that. That's gonna be good there. All right, kill the throttle. I think I actually wanted to kill the throttle a little sooner, but it'll be all right. Now, I don't really want to climb, so... You can see how quickly this flight goes. I mean, we're already... Let's track our position. Let's zoom way in. You can see we're already, you know, out of Florida, basically. 0 degrees on the horizontal situation, so we're aimed exactly where we need to be aiming. 270 or so kilometers to go. Go a little bit more, then we'll engage that AOA hold. And once again, I'll try to remember to make sure that I'm descending right before I engage. Now I'm going to be looking at whichever of those numbers is smaller. Right now it's saying the range is about 200, but it's showing that number about 180. So I'm going to look at the smaller number this time. Okay, we are descending, which is what I want. And just arbitrarily, I'm going to say when I'm 100 kilometers out, then I'll engage. Actually, let me put in just a bit of bank here first, get all centered up. There's about 100. Just bank a touch first.
Right. Mach 9.
Just brake.
Warning, wing stress.
Wing stress again.
System reset. Mach 8.
I think I probably still want to brake even sooner than that, because you can see how quickly the distance just goes by, but... See if we can brake a little harder. By brake harder, I just mean pitch.
Mach 7.
Or rather, increase the AOA. So it looks like I'm still going to go past the pace, which is okay. As long as I don't go too far past it, I'm okay with that.
Mach 6.
But I will brake sooner if I want to do this flight 90%. Again, because 100 kilometers moving that quickly is not going to be enough.
Mach 5.
So according to MapMFD, we're about 25 kilometers past the base. That's fine. I mean, it's not ideal.
Mach
4. And I'm gonna let myself slow down a little more this time before I...
Mach 3.
All right, we'll go with that. And again, I gotta come to this view just to zero out the trim. I'm gonna
warning wing stress
careful.
System reset.
Same plan as last time. Basically gonna have to turn around, so more or less lay over onto the canopy and dive back in.
Warning wing stress.
Be careful about the wing stress.
System
Let's
reset.
Not destroy the vessel again. It's a very expensive piece of machinery.
Mock warning, wing stress. System
taxpayers
reset.
Aren't going to appreciate if I break another one of these. Okay, I think I'm more or less pointing back toward the base. Bring up this view for a minute just so I can kind of get a better idea where I'm going. Forty kilometers away from Habana. And it seems like I'm more or less flying straight toward it.
Subsonic.
So I think if I had started the braking at Well, the thing is, I was going to start it at 100, but I ended up going a little bit late. So maybe 125 would be better. Then I wouldn't overshoot, at least not by this much. Maybe even 150. It's going to be difficult to make it actually to the runway because I need to fly what I'm looking at here in glide slope 2. It's telling me I need to come follow this line, and essentially here's the runway, so I'm going to have time to get in front of the runway and then turn around a pretty good angle. I think I can do it. Have to watch my down pitch a little bit so that I don't slow down too much. It's one of the things I really like about this particular MFD for this kind of flight is that if I didn't have glide slope 2 over there on the left, I would really not have a good idea at all of how I needed to be positioned, because I'm looking, you know, there's no detail really. I got a blue sky, I can tell with a Horizons app, but that's really about it. And then Map MFD certainly doesn't give you enough information for landing. But glide slope 2 pretty much does. It gives me more or less all the information I need. So here, let me start. Man, I don't know if I should start banking in just yet, though. I want to get a little further down before I turn in. Because if I turn in right now, you can see it's going to be an awfully tight. Of course, can't really see what I'm pointing out there. Down to about 200 meters a second. We're still 7,500 meters up. Alright, let's start turning in. And the other thing is, you can see those plus indicators in the MFD. It gives me a really good idea, like if I continue at this bank angle, you know, where am I going to end up? So in terms of speed, this definitely is costing me tons of time by passing the base by so much. So I'll have to work on that. There's a lot of extra lines on that MFD that I kind of don't need and wish weren't there. Really, the only thing I'm looking at is that green indicator for where the runway's at, and the plus indicators and green indicator for where my current position is and my predicted path. All right.
5,000.
Now I'm gonna start dumping altitude, because I already know that I'm more or less in front of the runway, sort of. I'm gonna do a hard turn here and get right in front of the runway, 4, but with 000. Lots of down pitch. Okay, there's the runway.
1,000.
Okay, I need a little bit of air time on the air brake.
700, 600, 500, 400, 300. Warning, gear is up.
Yeah, I know the gear's up.
200. Warning, gear is up. 100. Gear down and locked. 50, 40, 30. 20, 15, 10.
And here we come in for the landing.
9.
Watch the vertical speed.
7, 6.
Put the air brake back
4,
out.
2. Wheels down.
And brake. Get wheel stop here in a moment.
100 knots.
And I can switch back over to this view. just to get a benchmark here.
Wheel stop.
Let's say wheel stop at 13 minutes and 50 seconds. It's like a couple seconds less than that. So that gives me some kind of an indicator to go by. I think I can beat that time by easily 3 minutes, 4 minutes. You can probably do this flight quite easily in under 10 minutes. So that just gives me some idea, though, of what I need to do. So on the next attempt at this, which I don't know when it'll be, but a couple things I can do differently, mainly just to brake sooner. That's going to be the big thing. I don't really think I want to try to increase my velocity much more, because the distance is just too short. Why am I like bouncing here? No idea. Oops.
Hitch.
I had no idea what all that bouncing was about. So yeah, I don't think I want to try to increase the velocity, at least not until I get more of an idea of when to brake. But I think I'm going to go for 125 kilometers next time I try this. Because if I can brake and then come out just like you do at wide awake, where when the nose comes over, you're looking at the runway, or at least looking at the base, that's going to cut a bunch of time off. So, all right, well, I hope you enjoyed this flight attempt. At least this time it was successful. So if you liked the video, like it, as always. And if you didn't like it, that's all right. Thumbs down. More importantly, leave comments down below, because I like to get discussion going on the videos. Makes things more interesting, not only for myself, but for people who come in and watch the videos. If they got something to read down in the comments area, that's always more fun. Look in the description for links. In particular, I have an FAQ. That's a frequently asked question. A lot of people always seem to miss that. It's at the very bottom. So questions about what kind of video recording software I use, what are my hardware specifications, add-ons, all that kind of stuff. It's answered in the FAQ, so check that out. And if you're so inclined, look for my Facebook fan page. I've got something like, I don't know, I think we're closing on 300 fans on there now, maybe 200, I forgot the number. Check that out as well. I post all my videos, but you also get to see a lot of other posts that I don't get to put up on the YouTube channel, things about things that are going on, you know, in the news with regards to spaceflight, and articles, pictures, videos, other things that I see that I find interesting. I put all that on my Facebook fan page, and that's about it. I will see you in the next video.